In this screencast, we will look at approaching a single reaction material balance that involves a recycle and purge stream. We'll use an extended reaction method to help us solve for an unknown flow rate and composition. And so with that, let me introduce the problem. So here we're making methanol by reacting carbon monoxide and hydrogen catalytically in a reactor. We know our fresh feed composition is 30% carbon monoxide. There's a stoichiometric proportion of hydrogen that's added, and we have an inert of nitrogen that takes up 10 mole percent. Now the reactor is not efficient, so we separate the methanol from the unreacted gases using a condenser and recycle the gases back into a main feed line to the reactor. The recycle ratio is something we could control and is initially set to 3 moles per hour recycle stream to every 1 mole per hour that's in the fresh feed. So this recycle stream contains 25% nitrogen gas. So the liquid product from the condenser is essentially 100% methanol. Based on this information, we want to determine the rate of methanol production in moles per hour for every 100 moles per hour of the fresh feed. We want the rate and composition of the purge gas, and we want the overall and single pass conversions for this process. I suggest pausing this and trying to work it out for yourself before checking the work. We should start by drawing a picture and then labeling all streams with known information and unknown variables. We are told that we have a fresh feed that's coming in to our reactor. Out of the reactor, it's entering a condenser. I'll just put a big C. Out of the condenser, we have a gas stream that is split. Part of the gas stream is recycled back to the fresh feed, and the other part is purged out of the process. We also have a liquid product stream that comes out of the condenser. So this is just a really rough schematic of what the process looks like, but now we can start filling in some of the information and I'll draw this a little nicer. So here's my process. I've written the reaction down in the reactor. Now we weren't told specifically what the reaction is, but we are told that it's carbon monoxide and hydrogen to form methanol. So using our stoichiometry, we could quickly figure out that there should be 2 moles of hydrogen per mole of carbon monoxide coming in. Now we're told that 100 moles per hour, a fresh feed comes into the process. We know that it's 30 mole percent carbon monoxide, 60 mole percent hydrogen, 10 mole percent nitrogen. We are also told that it's 3 moles in the recycle stream per 1 mole in the fresh feed. We're also told that the composition of the recycle stream is 25 mole percent of nitrogen gas. Now if it's 25 mole percent here in the recycle stream, then we know nothing changes here at the mixing point. So the composition should also be 25 mole percent and 2 in the purge, as well as what leaves the condenser. So what other information do we have? We know that the composition of the liquid stream is effectively 100 mole percent methanol. So that's pretty much all we know in terms of the streams. So since we don't have flow rates for 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, I'm going to put variables associated with those flow rates. We also don't know the composition entering or leaving the reactor, so I'll write those out. So now we have our diagram for the process, all streams labeled with our known values and any unknown variables. So it looks like a lot of unknown variables. Kind of wonder if we could solve this. So to do a quick analysis to determine if we can solve this problem and where to start, we should do a degree of freedom analysis. And I always like starting with an overall balance. So we'll draw our box around the overall process. We only care about the stream entering and the streams leaving. So to do a degree of freedom analysis, we determine the number of unknown variables. So we know, based on just the overall balance, we know that N5 is unknown, that Y5C is unknown, that Y5H is an unknown, and N3. So we have 4 unknown variables. We then add the number of reactions that are involved in this process. And we have 1 reaction. So we have a total value of 5. We subtract the number of species balances we could perform. So we could do a balance on carbon monoxide, hydrogen, nitrogen, and methanol. We also subtract out any relationships we know. And we know that in our purge stream, the mole composition must add up to 1. So we have 1 relationship that we could use. So that gives us a value of 5. So we take 5 and we subtract out what we know. We basically have 5 unknowns and 5 relationships or 5 equations. So we get 0 degrees of freedom and we can solve this problem. So where do we start? Now usually an inert could help us out some. And we have an inert nitrogen that enters in 1 location and exits in 1 location. So using an overall balance on nitrogen, we should be able to calculate the flow rate of the purge stream. So based on what's coming in for nitrogen, we have 10 mole percent times 100 moles per hour of fresh feed. This must be equal to what's leaving the process. We're assuming steady state, no accumulation within the process itself, and nitrogen does not take place in the reaction. So this must be equal to 0.25, 25 mole percent, times N5, the flow rate. So we can solve for N5, and I get 40 moles per hour. So I'll plug that information into my diagram. Now we could do the same thing for carbon monoxide and hydrogen, but we have to use our extent of reaction to help us out, since they're involved in the reactor. So for carbon monoxide, one reaction consumes one mole of carbon monoxide. So we have our extent of reaction, or the number of reactions that take place, is equaling the number of moles that come in to the process. So we have 0.30 times 100 moles per hour minus what leaves the process. So this is Y5C times 40 moles per hour. So basically what comes in minus what comes out must be what was consumed, or the extent of our reaction. We have two unknowns in one equation, so we're not going to be able to solve yet. But if we do the same thing for hydrogen, I can write out the extent of reaction as equaling what comes in minus what comes out. Now hopefully you've caught that I've made a slight misjudgment. For every reaction that occurs, we lose 2 moles of hydrogen. So we need to take our extent of reaction and multiply it by 2 to make this accurate. So now we have 2 equations and 3 unknowns. So we're still missing something. We do know from our relationship that the mole fraction in the purge stream must add up to 1. So now we have 3 equations, 3 unknowns. We could solve for the composition of our purge stream and the extent of reaction. So I'm going to solve for it and plug those values in now. So I get the mole fraction of carbon monoxide in our purge as 0.25, and the mole fraction for hydrogen is 0.5. Our extent of reaction is 20 moles per hour. It's important to note that there are units on the extent of reaction. So we know the composition of the recycle stream, since it has to be the same as the purge. So I'll transfer those values over to the recycle stream. And now we could use this information to do a mole balance on the mixing point to determine the number of moles entering the reactor. Now, at this point, we figured out how many moles per hour are leaving in our purge. We actually know how many moles of methanol are produced. We know from the reactor that 1 mole of methanol is produced per reaction. And our extent of reaction is 20 moles per hour. So that must mean that what's leaving the condenser is 20 moles per hour of methanol. So we have our purge stream, our recycle stream, and our product stream of methanol. And that almost answers everything we were looking for in the problem. But we wanted to know what the single pass conversion and the overall conversion was for this process. And the only way to calculate the single pass conversion is to know the amount of moles coming into the reactor and what's leaving the reactor. So as I said, we could use the information from the recycle stream to help us do a balance at the mixing point over here to solve for the values entering the reactor. So let's set that up. So with 3 species being involved in this process, we could write 3 material balances. And so I've written an overall balance, which is the easiest one. We know 100 moles of fresh feed plus 300 moles of our recycle must be the moles entering our reactor. We did a carbon monoxide balance, as I've written here, and a hydrogen balance, so we could solve for the composition Y1C and Y1H. So when I solve these equations, I get the following for the composition entering the reactor. And as I mentioned, we need the information leaving the reactor, so we need to do a balance around the condenser. So before we calculate N2, we need to know N4. And we do know the composition of N4, it must be the same as the recycle stream and the purge stream. And the flow rate's pretty easy to see. It's just going to be the 300 moles plus the 40 moles. So let me fill that information in for N4 so that we could use N4 and our 20 moles per hour of methanol to determine N2 and the composition of that stream. So let me walk through an example balance. Let's do this for carbon monoxide. We know into the condenser we have Y2C. This is going to be multiplied by N2. And this has to equal what comes out, which is 0.25 times 340 moles per hour. Now we know we could do an overall balance to figure out N2. N2 is equal to 340 moles per hour plus the 20 moles of our methanol stream. So a quick balance for each component can give us the composition that we're looking for. I'll plug those values in. So now we have all the information for our compositions and our molar flow rates. We could calculate the single pass conversion and the overall conversion. Let me do the single pass conversion first. Now the idea of single pass conversion is basically the amount of moles that reacted out of the amount of moles that could have reacted. So let's look at carbon monoxide. We have 0.26 mole fraction times our 400 entering. We subtract out what left. So that's 0.24 times 360. So we have a certain amount entering, a certain amount leaving, the difference being what's reacted, that amount of reaction over what could have reacted, so the 0.26 over 400 is going to give us our single pass conversion. So I get 17%. We get 17% conversion of carbon monoxide in this reactor for each single pass. Now to do an overall conversion on the process, it's the same mentality, but we use the values that are entering and leaving the process. So we have 30 moles of carbon monoxide entering, a certain fraction leaving. This over what entered gives us an overall conversion of 0.667, or roughly 67%. So you can see that we get 67% conversion of carbon monoxide in this process, even though our single pass conversion was only 19%. Hence the importance of our recycle stream. It allows us to recycle some of the unused reactants back into the feed of the reactor so that they do react, thus increasing our overall conversion of those incoming fresh feed materials. So to reiterate, start with the diagram, label your knowns and unknowns, and then perform a degree of freedom analysis using one of the three methods for reactant balances, whether it's a molecular species balance, an atomic species balance, or using the extended reactions as shown here. Then it's just a matter of math. Hope this helped.